family just ripped me off for dead. And then they were like, no, you do not tell anybody about this disease. My husband would go, when we were in the house talking about it, he would go, shh, don't say anything, because the people outside might be able to hear. And I'm like, George, I'm talking in my own home. You don't know. Walls have ears. That's what he would say. And my mom was like, no, don't tell anybody. My dad was like, if you tell anybody, we'll disown you. And down my mother's block, my father told half the people that I had a heart condition and that I was to be dying soon. And my mother told the other half that I had a brain tumor, which was cancerous, and I was to be dying soon. And I never know which one they told which thing to. So I was always getting, like, you know, believe me, it was hectic.
I don't feel anymore that it's about shame or guilt. You know, it's part of who Marina is. I'm Marina and I'm HIV positive and that's who I am. And there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with that. You know, how other people perceive it, that's their problem.
I'm just doing this because I know if I would have saw something like this, it would have helped me. You know, to just, because in that moment of aloneness, it's like this, it's a hole, it's a black hole. And everything you hear and see, even if there's some positive in it, all you hear is the negative. No one is saying you're not alone. No one is saying it's okay. You know, you can still love yourself and have AIDS. You can still live and have AIDS.
I decided to write this poem one night when I was feeling a lot of the pain that dealing with this epidemic has brought me and my sisters. Just like a wildflower is the continuity of life. For we shall be strong enough to absorb all that can help us around us. Knowledge, empowerment, wisdom. For we are the bearers of life. I see what is here. I know what is there. But if I'm silent, then she will not hear. Cause my cry is for all women. No matter what kind, no matter what color. Most of the time forgotten. Bewildered and betrayed. We are intimidated and forsaken by ego-hoarding men and sometimes women that turn their back on their sisters. If it doesn't apply, then baby, throw it out the window. The rest, oh yes, the rest. We can unite, pull in all the sisters towards the continuity of life.
Doing a video is very important because this can show other people that, no, you're not alone in this fight. And, yeah, there are people who are living with this and fighting every day, fighting to survive and fighting to struggle. There are many fights. You know, there's the fight that you have within yourself as a person to continue to live. There's the fight that you have with the establishment because they're not doing enough to help us to survive this. And there's the everyday fight and struggle that we have in everyday life, you know. I decided to do volunteer work at an AIDS organization. It was called the Bronx AIDS Task Force at the time. And while there, I would sit down and in between doing the work, I would read all the literature they had and all the information that they had on AIDS and everything that was updated on it. And one day, they told me that they had there was a program coming. And it was called Health Force, Women Against AIDS. And they wanted to train women in the community who were either HIV positive or had relatives who were affected by AIDS. and they wanted to train us to go out and be community educators.
Hi, my name is Cynthia Masonet. I'm a grateful recovering addict, and I'm also HIV positive. And this is?
Ada Keyless. I'm 33 years old, and we're graduating today, Health Force Women Against AIDS. And hopefully, we're going to make the difference.
Sin mujer una semana. Dios ha escuchado mis plegarias y mi suegro está en cama.
Victoria para nuestras mujeres combatientes contra el SIDA. Victoria para el pueblo que lucha por construir una comunidad nueva. Honor y gloria a todos nuestros muertos por el SIDA. Gracias.
I am a Latina, HIV-positive woman who has joined the millions of women in the struggle against AIDS.
Hermanas, adelante. Vamos para adelante con la lucha que está presente. Fuerza y el poder a la mujer.
Mamá lo tiene, dale soporte, dale sus abrazos, dale su, juega con ella, sal con ella, dale la fuerza que ella necesita, porque como mi mamá dijo, cuando ella primera vino, ella estaba bien flaca, y nosotros la tenemos gorda, como tú ves, está gordísima.
My T-cell count was real low. And as a matter of fact, my T-cell count ever since my kids been pulling with me has gone up to 890, and I'm weighing 130, you know, and I'm not going to die, you know, I'm not going to die. Well, I need that no time soon, you know, and I want to help women. I want them all to realize that you need unity within your family, within yourself and your community to be able to outlive this disease.
She's a big part of the support of our family. Come here, Scorpio.
We today became the backbone of this community because we're going to go out there and fight the struggle against AIDS.
Eso es lo que este programa significa para nosotros. Nosotros llevar nuestra lucha y la lucha de nuestra comunidad hacia adelante para pelear y combatir contra el SIDA.
Y yo quiero también inventar unos remedios que para la gente del SIDA, para que viva más y haga y haya más futuro en este mundo latino y negro, especialmente latino y negro, porque eso es lo que está sufriendo más del SIDA.
Sigue pensando, Rosita, a lo mejor saque la cura. ¿Eh?
Gracias. From that small project, so many doors have opened up for me. I have met so many people and have done so many things. My experience with Baker House, which was a homeless shelter for people with AIDS, was a very rewarding one because just a few years before then, I may have been in the same situation they were in, and I was able to share my experience with them and showed them where I had been. You know, going into a place like Baker House, you can really see the problems that women have, you know, and the issues that they're faced with, and how the government is not addressing these issues. And, you know, a lot of times I felt very frustrated there, very frustrated because I felt like maybe there wasn't much I can do. But just being there and supporting them and giving them guidance and helping them and empowering them was enough.
As I found out 5 years ago, is that
if God forbid I ever do get sick, she'll have had all this time to have worked through it before if anything ever does happen, that she'll be prepared for it.
She stood behind the curtain listening. Ay, callaita. That's how she found out I even got high. For being nosy in my pocketbook where she didn't belong. So then, you know, she heard, like, you know, being tested and all that. A lot of men don't like using condom, and then that's where it comes in that, you know, they were like, why?
Right.
You want me to use condom?
Right? You shouldn't have to deny yourself of having sex, I'll tell you that. Mm-hmm. That's something that you should never do. It's a beautiful act of two loving people. Mm-hmm. And just that condom should not mean that much that you deny yourself of the beauty of that.
When you started coming on Tuesdays, I'd be like, on Tuesdays, I'd be saying, oh God, can't wait, Marina's coming. Because, you know, you really spunk me up, you know? You let me express how I really feel. And, you know, I love you. Be careful going home now, okay?
I'll be fine.
Be safe.
I love what I do. I like being involved in AIDS work. I like doing education. I like doing prevention. I like doing reaching out to the community. I got involved with an organization called ACT UP, and I can't say enough about ACT UP. ACT UP is the AIDS Coalition to Unleash Power. And what I found out is that they're just not a bunch of people who make a lot of noise. They really have a cause from their heart, and they fight for what they believe in.
We are the members of the Latino Caucus, and we're here to talk to you about AIDS in the Latino communities.
You barged right in. You started making a statement that I happen to be not only familiar with, but I happen to be sensitive to. You happen to make a statement, and then you know, I don't play that game.
And I'm a woman with AIDS, mm-hmm. and I'm from the South Bronx community, mm-hmm. and I do AIDS work in the community. And how else are we going to be heard if we don't barge in and come in and tell you what's going on and
well,
what we need?
You
know
what's
about
going
the South
on.
Bronx. You know about Baker House. Are you familiar with Baker House? Do you know that Baker House is a home for homeless people with AIDS mm-hmm. who has no services, mm-hmm. who has no counseling? Mm-hmm. There's just this woman from church who decided to open up this house so that she can have homeless people mm-hmm. with AIDS in there. There's nobody coming down there to that Baker House on 3rd Avenue and saying, here, let us help you. What is this office doing about a place like Baker House? What is this office doing about places like rehabilitation centers and methadone programs? What are you doing directly in the community? You can sit up here and you can push paper and you can talk about what you feel, but who's coming right into the community where it's needed? Who's helping the women with children? Who's helping the women to know what's going on, to get empowered and to come out and to come out and speak for themselves? Who's doing this? You can push paper all day long up in your offices, but who's coming to 138th Street and Brook Avenue? Who's coming in that community and saying what needs to be done there? Who dares go down there? I go there. I live there.
So
when are you coming in?
So do I. Well, I said I will not commit to a meeting at this point.
But you will consider
it. I will consider it. That's
and
what I said.
What
consider.
Is involved
what is
in the consideration?
That's not a commitment.
What can you give us? What can you tell us? That we'll possibly see each other in how long?
We might well do that. I said I'm not going to commit to a meeting at this point.
We might well.
We might well do that.
So that's your politician answer.
Then you have,
well, that's your
you
answer are to the community. You are a typical politician, and you claim not to be.
We let him know that we were there for a reason, that we were there and we meant business. And then we went outside his office and we demonstrated outside his office, and there were television interviews, and the Spanish media came.
Los manifestantes dicen que la situación es dramática aquí y no en el Golfo. Incluso algunos de los que están protestando aquí sufren de la mortal enfermedad.
Varios activistas entraron en la oficina del presidente del condado y le entregaron un diploma.
Jeannie, I met when I went to Atlanta. And when I went to Atlanta, it was the first time I was exposed to women from other states with the illness. And I just knew that there was this powerful woman there that can get a message across, you know. And she's got this beautiful little daughter, too.
I come real far away. I come from Chicago to come here and talk to you today about that I have AIDS. And I have
I feel sad for those people who die, you know, always holding that secret and always not knowing that if they were to able to share it with the next person, that they won't be hated for it. And I was afraid, too, that I would be hated for saying, like, to this person here or to you even, hey, I have this disease, you know, and people are not hearing that I, as a woman, a mother, have this disease, you know, always afraid to admit that, and then wind up dying with that heavy, you know, alone. You die alone like that. I don't think I'll die alone if I have to die with this disease. I have all of ACT UP. I have all of Chicago Women's AIDS Project. I have been blessed with so many good friends and people that I've met that are more valuable to me, you know, than the old people that I knew that, for example, would have hated me. And each time that I came out and I said something, you know, pertaining to the virus and how it was affecting women and children, and I saw that my father didn't disown me, although he threatened to, you know. And after all these times, now my father sits back and he says, I'm proud of my daughter. Carol Hayes approached me at the Chicago Women's AIDS Project and offered to send me to San Francisco. But it was for the boycott of the 6th International Conference on AIDS. So into it, I could not believe it. And but before then, I believe what happened was they were having an overnight vigil at Cook County Hospital, and I saw what ACT UP did there, and I was a part of Ward 65 at Cook County Hospital being created, insofar as, you know, volunteering and things like that. And when they created it, they said it was for men and women, but I also watched for an entire year the word 65 be womanless. So when ACT UP did what they did, and then the next day, see that Ward 65 got, PWA ward, AIDS ward, got opened up to women on a nonviolent, in such a nonviolent but yet very politically done way. It was really, really cool the way they did it. I was so convinced that ACT UP's, you know, ACT UP likes to say it's a little militant, but I don't think it's really, you know, I mean, we don't go around clubbing police officers and things like that.
No, they club you.
They club us. But, you know, I was just like, from that point on, I was convinced, and I've been an activist ever since then. And I love going to jail on my own, what do you call that, where it was my doing, instead of being hauled off to jail for a crime, you know. I really, really love being going to jail for a good cause.
Irma is just this fascinating woman, I think. First of all, I'm so impressed with the way she dances. I love the way she dances. And she has this aura about her.
The key to all of it was that I had accepted myself, that I was going to, like, take care of myself a little bit before the bottom fell out. And it turned around really nice, you know. I put on weight, so I started feeling better, you know. I started responding to the medication, so I wasn't as tired. And I started meeting people that were dealing with this, and that was so, so relieving. I have to say that the prison system is overwhelmed with the issue of HIV. There's just no way that they could have predicted handling as many women, you know, infected with the HIV virus that are locked up, like, literally like animals in there. It's horrendous because, see, their own ignorance and their own problems that they have within that system are not conducive to any sensitivity when a woman is diagnosed with AIDS in prison. You are isolated, you are stigmatized, you are humiliated, and your confidentiality is constantly violated amongst the medical staff. And I say this from experience.
Dancing.
What does it do for you? Wow. Dancing is my connection to whatever wonderful energy it is that put all this together. It's just something that I always go back to. Major crises, losses, deaths. It's just something that kind of just brings me back and gives me strength to just go on, you know?
Hola, les habla Celia Cruz y mi cabecita de algodón. ¿Saben ustedes que desde el comienzo de la epidemia del SIDA, sobre 44,000 personas han muerto en los Estados Unidos y de esas, cerca del 30% han sido personas latinas? El SIDA no discrimina raza, sexo ni edad. Mientras encontremos una cura, tenemos que educarnos para protegernos.
Para más información, llame al 1-800-344-7432.
It's not gonna happen to me.
Not gonna happen. It's not gonna happen.
Not gonna happen to me.
I was really shocked when I found out I was infected. I didn't think anything like this could ever happen to me.
HIV what?
I don't know anyone that has it.
Do I look like I would have it?
You can't tell by looking at someone if they have HIV. I look healthy. I feel good. But yet I'm very infected.
Too busy.
I don't think about it.
Not a day goes by that I don't think about the fact that I have HIV.
I just got married.
You're married.
I got the virus from my husband. I didn't know he was a drug user.
It's not a big deal.
I've lost my home, my wife, my business.
Only certain
people get it.
People don't typically think of me as the type of person who would have HIV, but I do.
I just want it to go away.
I just want it to go away.
Basically, I just want to live. That's the most important thing to me.
You could be putting yourself at risk. Call 1-800-342-AIDS.
Come on, Marisol. Prove your love for me.
I do love you, Julio. But if you really love me too, then use this.
A condom. Don't start that again. You think I am? I see you really don't love me.
But Julio! I do love you, but not enough to die for you.
Love is not worth dying for. AIDS, it can happen to you. Protect yourself. Get the facts.